today. We're going to talk about the back squat. There's a couple variations of squats you can do. I'm going to go over basics. These are just the basics of what I teach my athletes when we go into back squat. Okay, I have my back squat, I have my barbell across my back, behind my neck, and my shoulders. Squatting down, standing up, way back, pull, up and down. Okay, I'm going to go over some of the cues that I'm looking for. Now, first, to get under the bar. When we put our athletes in under the bar, we'll make sure they're all the way up underneath the bar, so that when you come up and stand up, you're going to stand the bar straight up. Right? We don't want to pull it back, pull it back. Bring it all the way up underneath and stand straight up, and then we're going to take a step back. Now, the bar position on our shoulders, we're on our back. Take our hands back here, and you'll feel right here, it's called the spine of the scapula. Okay, it's a bony pole portion right here. You're going to place the bar up above that area, okay, on the meaty part of the trap, right up in this area right here. That's predominantly the bar positioning that I'm looking for. We want to make sure we keep the bar off our neck. We don't want to hide this neck here. Shouldn't be hurting your neck when you squat, okay? Get underneath, position that bar. I'm going to stand straight up and I'm going to get back. Now my hand positioning on the barbell, I'm going to face the camera instead of demonstrating from behind. My hand positioning on the barbell, I'm not really too overly concerned about that unless I have a person with some really bad form and technique and there's a position I specifically want them in with their hands. But for most of my athletes, I'm going to tell them, I don't really care where your hand position is on the bar, just as long as you have one thing. That's a tight grip on the bar. So if you were to take your hands, put them down your side, squeeze as tight as you can, you'll feel everything in your upper torso, upper back, everything's going to tighten up. Well, guess what? The same thing's going to happen when you grip your bar. You squeeze that bar as tight as you can, everything's going to tighten up in your upper back. Okay? Another cue would be to shrug your shoulders a little bit when you get up underneath the bar. Tight grip, and pull the bar into the trap. Your shoulders shrug. It's going to engage all those upper back muscles and give a good base of support for your spine to keep you like nice and stiff in the upper body. Alright, so now we've got our bar, we've got our weight, step back. We're going to step back a foot or two so that we're not going to hit anything. We want some space when we squat, but we still want to stay within our catch rails. Now our catch rails we want to set up in advance. And we want these high enough that when you squat down, the barbell will not lie ahead or rest on the rails. Okay? But we don't want them down so low that if you do go down, you put yourself in a position of injury where the barbell catches real low and you get squished like an accordion. You want these catch rails up high enough so that when you go, if you can't get up, you go down, you set the bar down, you crawl right out, you're nice and safe, and that's really the whole meaning, the whole reason for this. Okay, so now we have our barbell, we got a tight grip, we got our stance, now our stance, we want our feet shoulder width or slightly wider, toes forward or slightly angled out, okay? Typically, I say just a little wider than shoulder width, slightly angled out. This is my key position that I like to put my athletes in when we squat. We never squat with our toes in. Never squat with our toes in. In this position, now we're here, now we want to get in what's called our ready position. We're going to bend our hips a little bit, bend our knees, head up, okay? We're going to keep our head up, chin neutral or up, eyes straight ahead or angled upward the entire time through the lift. Don't look at the floor. Okay, don't ever look at the floor. Okay? Now I'm in this position. Now my first movement is going to come from my hips. I want my hips to break first and I want my knees to follow. Okay, so boom, I'm going to let my knees follow. At this point, I'm just going to squat all the way down. Now, how deep do I want to go? I want to go at least the parallel. Okay? Here being parallel. This being below parallel, okay? Either is fine as long as you maintain the correct form. But you have to get to at least parallel to really make the lift worth anything, okay? I always want our athletes getting parallel. I allow them to go all the way down as long as the form and technique stays correct, okay? There's no loading on the knees if it's done correctly. Now, when we do our squat, one thing we want to pay attention to, okay? We don't want the weight transferring into the toes. Heels lifting up off the ground. Our heels keep our knees back, keep them in line with our toes, pushing our knees, pushing our feet out, squeezing the glutes and quads, getting everything fired up, our core staying nice and tight. We took our breath. I didn't mention that. We take a nice breath, down, to put in our abdominal pressure, get in there, and we're going to come out driving that weight through the heels, tight grip, stand straight up under control. Do our reps and we'll repeat. That's the basics of our squat. Obviously, it can get a lot more technical, get a lot more technique involved. There's some powerlifting positions for squatting, a high bar, a low bar position. But that's the basics. Now, safety things. We talked about the squat, the safety grips. Always when you're squatting, you put bar, you put the plates on. Always make sure you put a clip on the end of that plate. You never want to squat, have a plate slide off the end, and that's going to teeter totter, and then when the stuff hits the floor, it hits someone else. Never a good thing. Also, you should always have a spotter. Okay, for spotting, you can stand behind your partner. Okay? Help them up. And I always instruct our spotters to get underneath, right here through the arms, their hands are right over the shoulders. Okay? And they'll actually squat down with the partner and come back up. If there's any problems with a partner leaning forward, their hands are right there, block a little, we can front squat and lift our partners up. Okay? It takes a little pressure. It's too much pressure, anything over 20 pounds, guide your partner down to the rail. If they can't stand up, guide them down, set them down on the rail, make sure everyone's safe, and get out of the way. If you're going for a big match weight, you may have three guys, have someone spotting from behind, two on the end is going to spot, be there at the barbell, okay? That way we can really control our weight, and make sure this is a very safe lift. This, potentially, for some people, myself included, could be the king of all lifts, okay? It starts with this, you can find a lot of weaknesses from this exercise, and it produces some tremendous results. It's phenomenal for injury prevention and strength, overall total body strength, okay? Thank you. Hope that helps out. The basics of the back squat.